Hello, thank you for joining me. Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, wherever you are in the world. I left a card out there. This is pick a deck, pick a card. So again, I've got three decks, one, two, three. So pick your number. I'm just going to put them to one side a minute. Okay, so we'll start with number one as normal. Okay, they have been shuffled, but I'll give them another quick shuffle so you can see me doing okay, so those of you who chose number one, your card is the Ace of Coins. There you go, that's quite a nice one to have. Okay, so this is the Crow's Magic deck that I'm using here. I will put the link in the bottom, in the just underneath, so that if you want to see some more of this deck, you can do. Okay, so here we've got the Ace of Coins then. The Ace of Coins often turns up when you're starting something new, especially if it's a new job, a new a position in the company. It could be even something to do with your health, because the coins is a health card as well, physical activity, things like that. So if you're starting on a new health regime or a new diet, that type of thing is also seen in this card. Okay, let me just stand it up there. Hopefully you can see that. Okay, yep, there you go. So bit like a scarab beetle, that is, isn't it? The way that's well, that, it reminds me of the scarab beetle anyway. The little ornaments that I've got from Egypt when I was over there are in that shape. So there you've got some wings on that coin as well. Wings are representative of flying high, movement, progression, moving forwards. So as I said, this is something new that you're starting. So those of you who chose card number one, maybe you are starting a new job or a new position in the company that you're already with. It's going to be quite lucrative for you, because the Ace of Coins is always a good card to have coming up in your spread. It can often bring money with it as well, so a bit more money coming into your pocket. I get the feeling as well with this card number ones, that this is also an indication that some of you will realize a talent that you didn't know that you'd got, something that's been hidden, something that maybe you wanted to try for a while and have never got round to. So this card is indicating you may have the opportunity to try something out and actually find that it may not be lucrative, but it could be for some of you. So it could be a creative project for some of you that you can turn into a money making program, or for some of you it could be just something that's like a sporty venture, for instance, that you've never tried and that you wanted to do, and it could be the start of a new health regime, or start of a new sporting hobby, that type of thing. As I say, this card is not just wealth, it's health as well. But it's an indication that things are looking up for you that chose card number one. Bit of a word warning as well, because when I'm looking at this card, I can see that, as I say, it looks like a bit like a scarab beetle with wings, but I can see it's sort of taking off. So in one way it's taking off in progression and moving forward, but in another way I get the feeling there's a bill coming in soon as well. So just watch your pockets. If you do get a bit more money, just put a bit aside for a rainy day, because you may need it quite soon as well. I think the universe provides. Just stop thinking about things, let the universe provide. If it brings you extra money in, especially if it's something unexpected. Put it to one side because there's something coming up that's going to need it. Probably not all of it. You should have some left at the end of it, but put it aside anyway, and just save a bit because you're going to need it. Right, what else am I seeing here? Well, coins is an earthy card as well, and the it looks like wings on that coin, but you could also see it as seeds because seeds are new ideas that are coming to you. But again, I'm going back to the new project, so I think this as well is maybe new ideas and things that you're already doing, number one. So it could be maybe a new branch of something that you're doing. And so if you possibly got your own business, for instance, maybe you're bringing something new into it, or if you've already got a health regime, maybe there's something that you're bringing new into that, because those seeds are new ideas, the putting forward new ideas, and then as you can see, they're growing bigger at the top, so it's just planting them and then growing them as you move forward. I'm going to pick you an angel card to go with this as well, number one. So here are my healing with the angels. Just give them a quick shuffle as well. Again, I'll leave the link for these cards at the bottom as well. Okay, so this one is listening. Right, so this is listening for opportunities for a start off. Are they going to balance there? Yeah. So yeah, this is listening. It's also listening for signs from the universe, because as I said to you, the universe will always provide you. So don't worry about things. Just let it go. If you need something, just put it to the universe, tell them what you need, and just let it go. But this is listening to the signs that are around you, listening for opportunities, because the Ace of Coins tells you there's opportunities coming in various things. It's listening to your intuition as well, listening to that gut feeling, that little voice inside your head. Use your intuition more as well. And also, speak to your guardian spirits, your angels, the universe, God, whoever it is that you talk to. Just pay attention to what they're saying back to you as well. As I say, they often send you signs, and well, for instance, they say that when there's an angel around you, see a white feather. But also listen for songs playing on the radio that could be an answer to your question. Signs, street names, all sorts of things can give you answers to questions that those that are around us will provide you with. So look out for those as well. The blue around this card, blue is a color of calmness, recovery, cover of a color of relaxation. And when it's with the Ace of Coins, it's a color of de-stressing. So maybe this is the answer to your questions already. Number ones, maybe you've already put out that you need a bit more money coming in, you need a new job, you need a new position that's a bit better than the one that you've got. And so the powers that be have actually listened to you as well. And so the blue is now taking some of that stress off you. Okay, so that's quite a nice card to have there as well. But just remember to listen to those around you as well, number ones. You know, other people as well can give you a good advice. Listen to their opinions, their advice, their suggestions. You don't have to take it, but when you do listen to other people, it gives them the impression that you're paying attention to them. And you know yourself, when somebody pays attention to you, then you feel a lot better. You feel like they've listened and they've acknowledged you, and you're more likely to support them in the future. Well, that's what you get as well when you say to people, "Oh, yes, I can understand what you're saying. I'll give that some thought." It doesn't mean that you need to take it on board. It doesn't mean that you need to follow exactly what they've said. But as long as you've acknowledged that they've said it, they feel a lot happier for it, and they're more likely to support you in the future. So that's a good card as well, because that's building bridges. Okay, so I hope you like that number ones, and I'll catch you next week. Thank you for joining me, and I'm going to go into card number two. So take care. Okay, so for those of you who chose card number two, just give them a quick shuffle. Okay, right, so for those of you who chose card number two, then we've got the Emperor there. And that's also quite a nice card to have. That's authority. But it's a nice authority. It's a fatherly figure or a grandfather figure. He's somebody who's watching over the children. He's got the staff there with the ankh on top. The ankh is life, it's a symbol of life. And he's wearing armor protection. He's got the tulips, I think it is, at the bottom there, the hills. Quite a nice card, that one. So quite a lot of symbology in that card, showing authority but showing a kindness to that authority as well, a gentleness to it rather than a warlike tendency. And so this is someone who I can who knows how to assert themselves, but in the proper manner, in a sincere manner. Somebody with integrity. So if that's you that I'm speaking to, card who picked card number two, so this is saying that, you know, if you want to put your point of view across, do it in a sincere manner. Maybe there's people that you need to speak to at the moment and you're not sure how to approach them. But if you just put your point of view across, say what you need to say, get to the point, but do it in a way that is gentle, not aggressive, and also, as I said before, sincere. Show integrity in what you're saying, and be willing to listen to their opinions as well. And even if you need to stand your ground, showing that you're listening to their opinions while you're standing the ground, can actually help your case. So just remember that one. Because the way he's sitting there in his throne, it's almost like he is standing his ground, isn't it? He's not budging. He's going to let everybody else run around him like kids, and he's just going to stand there, sit there and watch them and protect them. Maybe this is how you feel with your family at the moment, or your friends, or somebody in your life, because maybe they're running rings around you at the moment, or just being silly, just doing things that you're not agreeing with and thinking they're a bit childish or a bit maybe they're not seeing things clearly. Maybe you think that they haven't looked at the facts properly, but you're sitting there, you're going to stand your ground, and but you're also wanting to protect those that you love, like the two kids in the back there. So it's authority, but gentle authority. It's not somebody that's warlike or aggressive. You don't need to lose your temper. You don't need to bawl and shout it at people. You don't need to do that. It's something that's you can be assertive without forcing it. So that's what the Emperor is saying to you there, number twos. And the other thing I'm getting as well, number twos, is that the way he's sitting there, it looks like some kind of vacation, maybe going to some stretch of water for some of you, whether it's the beach or whether it's a lake or a river. But there's a lot of relaxation that I'm feeling from that card as well. That guy there's taking it easy. But his family, the two kids in the background there, they're somewhere where they can actually run around a little bit and just let off a bit of steam, let off a bit of energy. And the way he's holding the orb in his hand there, that's a bit like the world. Almost saying that the world is your oyster. So maybe you're going on a bit of a vacation there, a bit of a holiday. And what else am I seeing in there? You've got the cup there and the purple of his robes. It's almost a bit like wine, isn't it, going into the cup. And that as well, when you see something like that, it's symbolic of relaxing, of good times, enjoying yourself. The mountains in the background do say that you've got mountains to climb. So this is a period of relaxation before the next lot of hard work starts. But it's not impossible for you to get to the top. They're just there. They're saying that if you do want to climb these mountains and get to the top, we're here, come and do it. But also, if you don't want to, it's very nice where you are at the moment. You're very happy, you're very settled. You don't need to worry about things with this card coming up. This is a very nice, protective card. So I'm just going to pick you a Healing with Angel card as well. Okay, so the Healing with Angel card is divine guidance. Right, so this actually goes with the Emperor as well, because the Emperor is often seen as a divine card, a symbol of God or a symbol of Jesus or whoever it is that you follow, that you worship. Right, so divine guidance is telling you to look out for signs. As you can see there, that angel is looking at the star there. She's looking at signs in the sky. So it's not necessarily astrology or looking at the stars, but this could be signs from the powers that be that are sent to you. When you see an angel around, they say there's often a white feather, or should say that the other way around, shouldn't I? When there's a white feather, you often know there's an angel around. Okay, so look for signs. If you're planning anything or on your vacation or anything like that, just trust in divine guidance, trust in your own intuition, because we have the divinity inside us and it's our higher consciousness. So when you listen to your intuition, that gut feeling, that little voice in your head, it's your own divine guidance that's telling you things. Now that's basically what that card is saying. Trust in that divine guidance. Don't be afraid to say a little prayer if you want to. Maybe you're somebody that doesn't say them very often. I'm one of those people as well. I believe in God, but I don't follow any particular religion, so I don't think it's necessary. It's what's in your heart. But trust in divine guidance. As I say, you've got the assertion there, but gentle assertion, relaxation as well, good times around you. So I don't see anything to worry about there. I'm not picking up any problems or worries. It's your choice whether you wish to continue climbing the mountains. But if you decide not to, you've got a nice setup there. All the grass is green, you've got the water. He looks very relaxed. You've got flowers growing. Though you could almost say that that's divine guidance as well, providing what you've got at the moment. Okay, so that's for you people who chose card number two. Hope you like that. Let me know in the comments below. As I say, I'll leave the links to these two decks below as well. Thank you for joining me, and I'll catch you next time. Okay, cards for those of you who chose number three. Right, so just giving these a bit of a shuffle. This is the Tarot of the Elves deck. And I'll leave the link below for you as well if you want to see more of this. So here we've got the Queen. And is that staves or runes? Let me just check. Okay, this is actually Queens, the Queen of Coins. You can see how often I use this deck, can't you? Yeah, this is actually the Queen of Pentacles, Queen of Coins. So she's an earthy queen, and I should have known, shouldn't I, by all the vegetation around her. She's got lots of fertility around her there. She's quite a grounded person. She's quite an outdoorsy person. So this card is saying to you, if you don't spend enough time out of doors, go on, get outside for a bit, go and do the garden, go and have a walk around the park, or get out into the countryside as much as you can. And ground yourself, walk barefoot on the grass. That's really grounding. And also with this card, I'm picking up a lot of green crystals. Look at all these greens standing out there. So green aventurine. And oh, what's that other one? Jade. And there's another one I'm picturing in my mind. I can't think of the name of it. Serpentine. Yeah, those three I'm picking up with this card. Those three crystals. They're very grounding. They also help you with your heart chakra. They open your heart chakra, and your heart chakra is green and pink. So the green crystals are really good for your heart chakra. You've got the blue there as well. It's very good for your throat and your third eye. The blue is a calming color, relaxation. But when it comes to your throat chakra, blue is also very good for communication. And as this is an earth sign, communication is quite beneficial for you. The air signs are really good at communication. They're the swords. But with the earth signs, they're more grounded, they're more, as I say, they're earthy. They're more into organization and preparing and structuring and planning. But to get your ideas across, you need communication skills as well. So you've got the blue there that's going to help you with that. And that looks to me like lapis lazuli, that blue there. That's a really nice nice deep blue color. You've got this queen standing against the water, but she's in charge of her emotions. She's not in the water. So the way she's standing on the bank, she's actually keeping control of her emotions. So if those of you who chose number three, if you're going through bad patches at the moment, you're the people who can stand your ground, who can be a pillar of organisation when everybody else is losing their emotions. You're the one that can get things done and can get things sorted out when you need to. Although I'm not picking up anything bad from this card at all. She's, oh, look at that, there's a disc there in the background. Why didn't I see that before? There's also news coming to you with this card. That's why she's got the horn there. The horn always, when you hear a horn, it's always symbolizing news of some kind or the arrival of something. If you think back to the ancient peoples, they used to blow a horn when the warriors returned home. So it's to announce the arrival or a message. So look out for that in the next couple of weeks, or even this week, actually. All right, so what else have we got there? A lot of growth around her, as I say, a lot of fertility. You've got the tree there as well, which is protection. The tree stands very firm. And she's standing almost parallel with the tree. And so there was something I saw. I'm going to be a tree today. I'll know. Oh, what was it? I can't think what it was. Let me just have a quick look because this will be something for you guys. Okay, I found it. Today I will choose to be like a tree. I will stay grounded. I will keep growing and I will know when to let go. Okay, so that's, I think, is very apt for number threes at the moment. So if there's anything that you've outgrown, get rid of it, let it go. Whether it's possessions that you don't need anymore, have a spring clean, get rid of the clutter. Or it could be even be people. If people are not keeping you grounded, sometimes they can drain you. Just let them go. You don't need to be funny about it. You don't need to be nasty, or you don't need to be upsetting or anything. Just let them go. And just keep yourself grounded, which shouldn't be too hard, as I say, because you're an earthy person anyway, standing on the banks there. You like your organisation, your planning, your structure. You'll get, as I said before, you'll get things done when other people around you are losing their heads. But yeah, if you do have people around you like that, then sometimes it is best to just let them go and do their own thing, and you stay well out of it if you need to, and only get involved if you need to, I should say. Let me just pick you a Healing with Angel card as well, number three is. We got healing. Well, that's a nice one as well because the coins are physical. They also represent the physical. So, earth, it can represent finances, it can represent the physical. So, we've got healing here. Now, she is surrounded by fertility, as I say. So, those of you who chose number three, I think the reason that card's come up, maybe you've got a healing gift. Maybe those of you who chose card number three have got something inside of you that could be very beneficial, not just to yourself, but to other people as well. and maybe a healing touch. It could just be that you've got the ability to listen to other people. It might be the fact that you can plan and organize and structure things for people, that they find it a lot easier to deal with things when you're around. But also, I think maybe you've got some kind of holistic abilities, some kind of natural healing abilities. Maybe it's with the herbs because she's got all those plants around. So it could be with the herbs, it could be with things like naturopathy or Reiki, tapping, or any of the natural healing methods. Maybe it's something that you've wanted to investigate, and maybe it's something that you do already and you just want to move forward with it. But that card there is saying that you've got that healing touch, that you can help other people as well. But also, don't forget to heal yourself as well. And whenever we do natural healing for people, it helps us as well. We also benefit from it. And so, through Reiki, for instance, you can do Reiki on yourself, but also when you do Reiki on other people, or if you're using crystals on other people or anything like that, it helps you too. We also get the benefit of it. Well, I found that I do anyway, especially when I'm using the crystals. Absolutely love the crystals. But again, on this card, you've got the blue, the blue. You've got the, well, there's a bit of blue in there, isn't it? But it's mainly green around the edges. I don't know if you can really see it on the screen there. Probably looks a bit more blue on the screen, I think. But to me, this is actually coming up as a bit like a turquoisey green, I would say. But I think on the screen it can come up as slightly different colours. But yeah, you've got the water there as well, and again, those two people are on the banks, away from the water, or very near the water, but not in the water. So they've got their emotions under control. And she's an angel. You can see her wings there. And again, you've got the greenery, you've got the tree in the background, the same as you have there, being strong and protective. And that's very much like a yew tree in the background there. And here you've got the lily pads in the water. And she's wearing a light blue dress. And as I said before, with the blue, the light blue especially is the throat chakra, and I felt the throat chakra with that there. So maybe that's something that needs a little bit of healing for you. Maybe it just needs to be balanced, and maybe it's just something that you need practice with, the communication skills. And maybe it's something that you want to take further, maybe in public speaking, or in teaching, training, advising, counselling, that type of thing. But that's also a part of the healing, isn't it? When you teach other people and when you counsel them or advise them, that's also part of healing. Okay, so that's the card then for those of you who chose number three. So thank you for joining me. I hope you like that. Leave your comments down in the bottom. I'll leave the links for the two cards, or the two decks, I should say, underneath as well. Click subscribe, click like, and tell me what you think. But thank you for joining me anyway, and I'll catch you next time. Okay, take care. Bye bye.